السلام عليكم ورحمة الله، لأنه عزم على نقل صورة الناس الحقيقية على عكس الصور السلبية عن الواقع، كان فنه تعبيراً صادقاً ودقيقاً ومتقناً ويحمل رسالة: إننا لم ولن ننساكم. من سوريا مع الرسام الأسترالي المحترف لوك كورنيش من الداخل، معكم زينب صفار، تابعونا. فنان أسترالي طرق أبواب العالمية بفن الستنسل هو فنان المرسام لوك كورنيش. الأسترالي الحائز جوائز عالمية عدة والذي ساهم كثيراً برفع مستوى هذا الفن لينافس الفنون التقليدية الأخرى، تمكن من خلق صور فريدة ومبهرة من الستنسل المصنوعة يدوياً. بعد 10 سنوات على انطلاقه في هذا الفن، حفر لوك كورنيش اسمه في أذهان الجمهور، وبسرعة نيزكية استطاع أن يثبت مكانه في عالم الفن المعاصر، وكان أول من ترشح لجائزتي الفن المرموقتين أرتشيبولد وسير جون سالمون بلوحة من الستنسل الكامل. لوحاته تكاد تشبه وضوحاً التصوير الفوتوغرافي، وهذا بحسب الخبراء هو شكل جديد من الواقعية المفرطة، وهو عكس ما شوهد من قبل. ولعل على مدى السنوات الخمس الماضية وبمشاركته في عدة معارض في أستراليا، كانت قدرات لوك كورنيش تسلب عقول الناس، ما مكنه من نيل العديد من الجوائز، بما في ذلك اختياره ليشارك في نهائيات جائزة مترو للفن عام 2011، وفاز بجائزة الفن الأسترالي للستنسل عام 2010، وفنان المرسام الأكثر شعبية في مهرجان ستنسل ملبورن عام 2008. عرضت أعماله الفنية ونفذ قسم منها في العديد من الدول، بما في ذلك بريطانيا وألمانيا وفرنسا وهونغ كونغ ورومانيا وإيطاليا والمجر وهولندا وكمبوديا، واليوم في سوريا في تدمر ومعلولة وحلب. لوك كورنيش فنان الستنسل المحترف يشرح ماهية هذا الفن الحديث وأسلوبه، وهل فن المرسام متفرع من فن الشارع، وماذا يقول عن هدف زيارته الثانية إلى سوريا اليوم وأحدث معارضه الفنية بعنوان الطريق إلى دمشق. Luke Cornish, award-winning Australian stencil artist, welcome to Min al-Dakhil from the inside, sir.
Thank you for having me.
You're always welcome, sir. Well, Luke, you have been a key figure in raising the profile of stencil art, actually, both within Australia and internationally. What do you mean by stencil art?
Stencil art is the medium in which spray paint is delivered onto a wall or canvas. Mm-hmm. So you cut the stencil out of paper or cardboard or whatever, and then spray paint over it. Mm-hmm. And you take the cardboard off and you get the image, mm-hmm. which is a sort of rudimentary explanation of the art form.
How did you get started with this stencil art?
I've always been artistic. Like, I always drew in school, mm-hmm. but I kind of reached a point in my maybe early 20s where I sort of needed something outside of what I was doing, mm-hmm. and I discovered stencil art. Mm-hmm. I just had a can of spray paint and I just thought I should.
How old were you then?
With that. I was about 23. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I discovered this passion and haven't stopped since.
When have you thought that you are so talented in the stencil art?
I've never thought that I'm so talented.
You are?
I know. Well, so I've been told, but I'm very self-deprecating, mm-hmm. with my art. Mm-hmm. I think it's important not to be too confident with your artwork. Mm-hmm. It's confident people make terrible artwork.
Yes, but yeah. You do very nice portraits.
Thank
and
you.
Murals, and everyone talks about them. Particularly that you don't do something which is just artistic, you do something with a message.
I wouldn't call myself an activist, but mm-hmm. I think strong artwork needs to convey a message, a positive message,
mm-hmm.
or raise awareness.
But sometimes it could be a negative message.
Sometimes it can. I guess mm-hmm. that's the difference between fame and respect.
Mm-hmm.
Like a lot of people just want to be famous, and that's not necessarily a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
People mm-hmm. sort of worshipping this notion of fame.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I think if people worship the notion of respect, the world would be a lot better place.
Definitely. Now, your work was described as such. I'm quoting, "The emotions that permeate through the eyes of his portraits have great depth, the shadows created by the stencils highlighting their anguish. His subjects all seem to share the same hardship and determination that Cornish himself has experienced, lending to a sense of dire reality in the unreality of his images." How do you describe your style, per se?
I guess I describe my style as photorealistic stencil art.
Mm-hmm.
So
instead, what do you mean by photorealistic stencil art?
Very similar to photography. Well, the end result is quite photorealistic. It looks mm-hmm. like a photo.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So you can have pretty basic one-layered stencils on the street, but my work usually involves a lot more than that. Some of my paintings have up to 1,000 separate stencils that go into it.
Mm-hmm. How do you manage to put them together? I mean, how much time do they take in order to get the final portrait?
I could take a day, I could take 2 months to make one painting.
Mm-hmm. Depending on what?
Yeah, depending on
the idea, the message,
what
the
I
sense.
Feel like doing.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, yeah. mm-hmm.
But it just comes with practice. I've been doing it for 15 years, so
mm-hmm.
I just kind of know the process of what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Now, they say that street art is visual art created in public locations, as we all know, usually unsanctioned artwork executed outside of the context of traditional art venues. The term gained popularity during the graffiti art boom of the early 1980s. Is stencil art an offshoot of street art?
I don't think it's an offshoot of street art. I think street art is a blanket term for a lot of different mediums.
Mm-hmm.
You can have stickers, paste-ups, stencils,
graffiti.
Mm-hmm. I think all of those come under the banner of street art. I think it's an integral part of street art. I wouldn't mm-hmm. call it an offshoot.
What is the portrait that you have done and you were so proud that the people could understand the message that you relate to them?
Yeah, I'm a big fan of the underdog. Father Bob Maguire's been working tirelessly in the community for mm-hmm. decades. And
so we're so impressed by what he was doing.
I was. Well, he's quite famous in Australia. Mm-hmm. Like he's on television, he's on the radio.
Mm-hmm.
But the portrait that I did of him was picked up in the Archibald Prize.
Mm-hmm.
It was a finalist in the Archibald Prize, which is Australia's
mm-hmm.
biggest Best. Portrait prize.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So that was the moment my career kick-started in Australia, mm-hmm. getting the recognition from being shortlisted into that prize.
You've traveled to a lot of countries and you have participated in many exhibits, art exhibits, you know, particularly about stencil art, and you've won lots of awards. Which country, which place captured your attention the most and why?
The Middle East, all of the Middle East actually. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It's the region that I have the most affinity to.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I just find the culture and the people
mm-hmm.
so warm and generous. It's a generosity you don't really experience anywhere else in the world.
Right, right, right. Yeah. Well, actually, one of your latest works, art exhibit, is Road to Damascus, which was inspired by a trip, by your first trip, I believe, to Syria. And a man whom you described a hero. Tell us more about this art exhibit, and who is this man?
This man is Khaled Al-Assad, who was the curator of antiquities at Palmyra
mm-hmm.
up until 2014, when he was executed by ISIS.
Mm-hmm.
I'd been following his story.
Because he did not give them, or he did not take them to the place where the ancient artifacts
so
was.
He hid the antiquities
mm-hmm.
when they came into town, and they pretty much said,
mm-hmm.
"Tell us where they are, we'll kill you."
Mm-hmm.
And he took the secrets to the grave.
Mm-hmm.
But I'd been following his story since long before ISIS had even arrived in Palmyra.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And I was deeply affected by what happened to him. And I never would have thought I'd have the opportunity to go to Palmyra.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, it came up and I thought, it's really
worth painting. Is it still there?
I'm not sure. Well, I painted his portrait on the amphitheater, which has been recently been demolished by ISIS.
True.
So I'm not sure if it's still there.
Mm-hmm.
But I have painted that on paper and I've been in touch with his son. So I'm going to try and meet with him while I'm in Damascus.
Thoughtful.
And give that portrait to his son.
Yes, to his,
to his
late father.
Yeah.
Now, Nanda Hobbs, contemporary art director Ralph Hobbs, said the exhibition offered a unique perspective on a significant moment in history. How did the people interact with your exhibit, with the portraits?
I think it was a very positive response because all we really see about this situation is from the media and it's all very negative.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted to put a human face on this situation.
Mm-hmm.
So I wasn't just painting pictures of demolished buildings and roadside bombs, I was painting the people.
Mm-hmm. Weren't you afraid of, you know, just having this whole art exhibit for something which is related to a war-torn country and which in your country, for example, and in various Western countries, they have a negative impression of what's going on
there. They do have a very negative impression. And
I
think I need to retain my integrity as an artist because I could just paint pictures of pretty girls and make millions of dollars.
Mm-hmm.
But that wouldn't satisfy me at all. I just think that would be quite empty.
Mm-hmm.
Like I was saying before, wanting to raise awareness and wanting to just seek the truth and disseminate the truth myself.
Mm-hmm.
It's, you know, people don't want to hang that stuff on their wall.
Mm-hmm.
But I'd rather make something that was true to me than just pump out decorations for people's lounge rooms.
Right. Now, Luke, allow us to stop now for a short break, and then after the break we're going to look and see with our own eyes how you performed a kind of portrait in Maalula also, and we're going to talk also about your trip to Aleppo and what you have seen over there. Have you done any portrait in Aleppo? Okay, then after the break. إذن فاصل قصير ونعود. لا تذهب بعيدا.
أثناء رحلته الثانية في سوريا التي تمزقها الحرب، أراد الفنان الأسترالي لوك كورنيش أن يرسم لوحة عابرة لكل ما يطلقه ويروجه الإعلام الرسمي الغربي عن هذا البلد. ذهب إلى تدمر وحلب ومعلولة وصيد نايا ورسم لوحة تحمل الكثير من الرسائل. فما الذي رسمه وما هي تلك الرسائل؟
One of the paintings I've done in Aleppo and in Maalula is a little portrait of Dora the Explorer.
Mm-hmm.
She's a child's cartoon character.
Mm-hmm.
I remember I asked a little Syrian girl who her favorite cartoon character was, and she said Dora.
Yes, all girls like Dora.
All girls like Dora. But the work I wanted to do in Syria this time was 100% for the children.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted it to be something they related to and something that would make them smile when they saw it.
Mm-hmm.
But I also love the irony of taking Dora to Aleppo, a place she's probably never going to visit, with the children that need her the most.
Tell us, Luke, about your visit to Aleppo.
So we visited Aleppo for 3 days. It was just mind-blowing, the destruction.
Mm-hmm.
It's just all gone in the center of the city. Nothing sort of prepares you for that.
You haven't ever seen such kind of destruction in your life?
Not in my life.
Not to the countries that you have traveled to?
No, not at all.
And where did you go there?
We stayed in the
You've drawn some murals over there.
Yeah, we were in the center of the city around the Citadel. Mm-hmm. And I did some work with kids at the National Library. Mm-hmm. I bought a whole bunch of art supplies in Australia and brought them over. Mm-hmm. And just got some kids to draw pictures. I just mm-hmm. said, draw whatever you want. Mm-hmm. And I bought the pictures off the kids. Mm-hmm. You know, just not a lot of money, but mm-hmm. I thought it would be nicer to, instead of just giving them money for
just
nothing,
to encourage them, you know.
But to actually, I thought it would be an empowering statement mm-hmm. to offer them money for the art that they've done. Because mm-hmm. I know that's given me a lot of power. Mm-hmm. Not a lot of power.
But what did you draw over there?
They drew the pictures of their houses.
No, you, yourself.
Oh, what did I draw?
Yes.
I did Dora, and I did another stencil of some little kids, little Syrian kids, uh-huh. giving the peace sign. Mm-hmm.
What about the eagle?
Oh, the eagle. It's a hawk, actually.
Mm-hmm. It's a hawk.
Is the national animal of Syria. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So I kind of thought that's something people would relate to or mm-hmm. appreciate.
You've also done this in Aleppo.
Yeah.
Upon visiting Syria last time and also this time, you highlighted that the aim of the visit was to build connections between the Syrian people and the Australians and to show the real Syria to the rest of the world. Now, after your exhibition, to what extent and after your first visit and after all the messages that you tried to relay through your art to the Australians about the Syrians, to what extent did the Australians interact with the crisis in Syria, with the Syrian people?
I'm not sure. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure how much difference this is going to make mm-hmm. after getting to Aleppo and seeing the size of Aleppo. It was humbling. It made me feel quite small. But it made me feel like, am I actually making any difference at all? But I think if I can just make a tiny little bit of difference, it's worth mm-hmm. doing.
Don't you think that you can make a difference through the art that you perform?
I do. Mm. But it's overwhelming. Mm-hmm. I think the scale of the destruction. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It's certainly not going to make me stop.
Because
trying.
You are an artist, you are so emotional, and you've seen something that you have never seen ever before.
It's going to take a while to process. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. But I strongly believe.
But at least you came here, Luke, and you have seen with your own eyes.
See, that's the thing. People want to exhibit in New York, and London, and Paris. They don't need art. They've got enough. Mm-hmm. If art's going to change the world, you need to take it to the people that need. Mm-hmm. The art.
Today it's your second visit to Syria.
Yep.
What is the goal of your visit this time? What was the goal of your first visit to Syria?
My only goal is to just make some kids smile.
Right.
Just a little bit. Uh-huh.
The first visit was with another...
The first visit I came with Father Dave Smith from Sydney, mm-hmm. who I box with a mm-hmm. couple of times a week. And he's been to Syria 5 times in mm-hmm. the last 5 years.
Yes, he frequents Syria.
He does. And he brought over a group of boxers. Mm-hmm. So I came with them to film for them. Mm-hmm.
But you didn't do any stencil art?
I did the stencil of Khaled al-Assad in Palmyra. Mm-hmm. But there was only a tiny chance we were going to get to Palmyra. Mm-hmm. And an even smaller chance that I was going to get a chance to paint his picture. Mm-hmm. But I had the stencils prepared just in case, and mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. then we found out we were going to Palmyra. Mm-hmm. I saw the opportunity, so I just jumped on it.
Tell us more about your forthcoming events and your future plans when it comes to stencil art.
I am planning to make a body of work from this trip, mm-hmm. which I'll exhibit in Melbourne, in Australia, in July, and I'd like to bring it back to Syria. I've been talking about having an exhibition at the Opera House in Damascus with the Australian Consul General. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah.
What impressions are you going to go back with when you travel back to your home country from this country, Luke?
I'm not sure. I think it's going to take a while to process mm-hmm. what I've seen this time. Mm-hmm. There's just so much... Yeah, it's quite devastating, actually.
Now, allow me to ask you my last question. What role do art and literature, but art in specific, play in shaping politics and ideology? This is a very general question, but I would like you to answer it, please. And how that has increasingly become lost in an ever more commodified and compartmentalized world?
Well, I think it's the role of the artist to hold a mirror up to society.
Mm.
You look back through history, all we know about ancient civilizations is the art that they made.
Mm-hmm.
It's the only thing that's going to be remembered in the future.
Mm-hmm.
Everything else is just materialistic and fleeting. I think art is what holds society together.
Right, Luke Cornish, award-winning Australian stencil artist. Many thanks indeed for joining us.
شكراً عبدي.
Always welcome, always welcome. إذا لقاء جديد في الأسبوع المقبل مع ضيف جديد وقضية جديدة ودائما من الداخل. للمزيد من التواصل بريدنا theinside@almaydeen.net وصفحتنا على الفيسبوك من الداخل. من كل فريق عمل من الداخل من كل الميادين من دمشق. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.